bakery, and we are going to be learning about star formation. Did you know that the space between stars, planets, and other large objects is not empty? It's filled with gas and dust, and this gas and dust moves around. Stars are born when huge amounts of gas and dust clump together, and the more gas and dust that clumps together, the more mass that that star will have. Now, mass is the amount of matter that is in one object. In today's experiment, we're going to see if we can collect enough gas and dust to make a planet or even a star. We're using kits from the National Informal STEM Education Network. We have lots of these kits in the makery. When Kidzu reopens, we can explore them together. We have many small balls here to represent gas and dust and space. So nebulae, which are filled with this gas and dust, are where stars are born. And we're going to use the hairdryer to move this gas and dust around. So in a real nebula, this movement can be caused by a stellar wind from a star, or even from shock waves from a cosmic explosion. So if we can get enough gas and dust to clump together into the container, then we will have a planet or a star if we get enough mass. So we're going to start with a little bit of amount of gas and dust in the middle, because that's what would happen in real life, but we want to get more. And now we're each going to get 30 seconds. We've got a timer here to see if we can get as much dust and gas as possible into our container. So Mallory is going to start. All right, let's have a look.
So,
this is what you got in your container. And we have a handy measurer here. So if you get a small amount of matter, you've got a gas giant planet. A little bit more, a low mass star, a little bit more, a high mass star. So let's see what Mallory got. Okay. I'm gonna help you dump that in.
I think this is my hand.
Oh, can you reach?
Ooh.
Okay, what about this? Okay, so you've got quite enough to make a gas giant planet. And now it'll be George's turn. Whoa, look at that. Low mass star.
Wow!
You also got a low mass star. Look like not maybe not quite as big as George's low mass star.
Whoa!
Okay, time to record our results. We have one gas giant and two low mass stars, which are generally cooler than the high mass stars. Now our own sun is an example of an average sized low mass star. Here's a picture of it here. And here is a hotter high mass star. And here is one of the biggest known stars ever, which doesn't even fit into our diagram. Thanks for joining us today. For more ideas, head to the Kidzu at Home website. You can also follow us on Facebook and Instagram. Bye.